not to the side of her, but behind her, and she sat behind you, behind her, and you came from behind and hit it. You don't set too many times where you actually set backwards like that, do you? I mean, I knew you set this way to your back, but I mean, from to behind you like that? That was a huge kill. I mean, it was kind of the exclamation point on getting this thing over with. Do you remember that point?
Yeah.
Did you anticipate her setting where she couldn't even see him?
I mean, I think our as a middle, especially, the goal is to be ready for everything. So even if you don't think she can make the set, I'm up in the air ready. Even if she's taking it with her platform, I'm up in the air. So, I mean, it's kind of just my goal is to be up every time and ready for it.
And it obviously was perfect because it was one of those slams down, and it kind of then just said, okay, you know, one more and we're out of here. How did you know she was at, obviously, did you know how close she was behind you or no?
Yeah, I mean, she's yelling for the ball, so you can hear
her. Oh, so she, okay, mm-hmm. So there's communication there.
Yeah, definitely.
How often do you set like that? Not very often, is it? Or it's, it's actually behind you?
I mean, that's like one of our play calls. We practice it a lot, so, I mean, we didn't set it a lot in this match, but when we did, she definitely capitalized on it, so.
Actually, how do you decide who to set to when you're getting ready to set? Is it a call play, or do you just kind of use your own judgment?
Both. At a serve receive, there's a lot of play calls, which a lot of times coach gives me. But during transition, we either have like a set play on like a free ball, or it's just whoever's calling the loudest and whoever I think has the best matchup.
Can you tell? And I don't know when you ever had a bad night setting. But can you tell when you're playing better and when you're on more than you're not in terms of setting?
Definitely, yes.
And what's the big difference?
I think just how crisp everything feels. Some nights it's really easy and you feel like you can't err, and other nights you feel like you just have to grind through it. So that's kind of like the big difference.
Okay, and Makenna, it all starts with you in terms of making the pass. Do you feel that way that, you know, and when you get to one, whether it's a dig or, I guess, a dig and a pass kind of combination.
Yeah.
When you see it come off your arms, in your mind, do you think, oh, that wasn't quite where I want it to be? Or, man, that's, now we can get a good set out of this?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, if we track the ball in well, like, sometimes I just know when it comes to my platform that it's going to be a good ball. But other times, you really have to, I mean, if it's a good serve, you have to fight off the ace and just get it high in the middle of court so Ash can run her offense.
Did you guys feel like offensively that you, I don't think you ever got out of rhythm or sync? I think it was kind of a steady, consistent offense all night.
Yeah, I felt like it was more of an offensive game than a defensive. I felt like we could score against them pretty easily, but we just had to grind it out.
Is that kind of what the scouting report was? It, you know, they were easier to than some teams to score against?
Not necessarily, no. We knew that there were good matchups that we would have, and there were some holes that we could exploit, but for the most part, we were focused on defense.
Last Saturday night was just kind of a weird, kind of strange match, and things just never got rolling. How long did it take to you to get that, shut the door on that and get ready for, you know, this week?
The next practice.
Yeah.
Was the next practice on Monday?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we went in the next time we got to practice with just clear heads, ready to grind it out and prepare for this game. And, yeah, I think we were just ready to move on and play better.
Are practices at that point focused on the mistakes from Saturday night or what you need to do tonight, or both?
Both.
Yeah.
A little bit.
It's a lot of preparation for the next team that we're playing, but also if we have weaknesses that we need to fix, we're definitely going to get them taken care of really quickly.
How about on a Thursday night match? Do you feel like you have more preparation for a Thursday night match than you do a Saturday night match? Or is there, I'm sure you've had some preparation already for Saturday night, no?
I mean, we watch film the day before for both matches, so we'll watch film tomorrow of Montana State, but I think it's more of just you're kind of ready for anybody with how our practices are set up.
And Lindsay knows more about them than we do at this point because she's been watching film for a whole bunch of time already, so she's more preparing and to teach us how to get them.
How do you feel? Pretty confident? I mean, I know there's one match at them. I'm sure you wish you could play again from last Saturday and get that one in your win column. With just the two conference losses? Do you feel strong? Do you feel like you can probably beat? I think you've faced all the top teams now.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you can beat any? You don't feel like you're like looking uphill with any of them at all?
I mean, anytime you wear a UNC jersey, you're always confident, so. There's a lot of pride in our team, and I feel like we had our two losses came against two very good teams, two of the top teams in our conference, but we still battled with them, and we know that when we face them in November, we'll be able to take care of business.
Yeah.